Yesterday, the rate of value-added tax, that's VAT, went up by 1% to 15%. This increase was announced by the previous Minister of Finance, Malusi Gigaba, in his February budget speech. Came into effect as planned on the 1st of April. To look at how Treasury planned for this, we joined now in studio by our guest from the National Treasury, Ishmael Mamoniat. He's the DDG for Tax and Financial Sector Policy. Good to have you. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you for interviewing me.
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's amazing how coyly everybody who's gone from, whether you're from SARS or from National Treasury, walk in and sit down and quietly sort of get on with it, knowing that you're not the most popular people right now, are you?
No, it's not very nice to be announcing a tax increase and talk about taking away more money from people.
Yeah, it is difficult. But I mean, if you can make the pill a little bit sweeter for South Africans to swallow, let's talk about why this happened and what the benefits are that we're going to reap from paying more when it comes to VAT.
Okay. Look, the reason why we're paying more is because there was a huge fiscal gap that's been emerging the last few years. In the October medium-term budget policy, we were looking at over 50 billion rands revenue gap, but that was reduced slightly to about 48 billion rand. And basically, we had this gap, and we needed to then reduce expenditure. There's a lot of expenditure cuts that were made, 86 billion rands over 3 years. And we had to also find new sources of revenue. So we needed at least 36 billion rand for the coming year.
Yeah.
And if you look at when you have a size of that gap, basically, there's only one of three taxes that you can raise. It can be the personal income tax, it can be the corporate income tax, or VAT. Those three taxes raise 80% of our national tax revenue. So, you know, personal income tax, about 3 years ago, we had increased by 1%, except for the lowest
income bracket.
Income bracket.
Yeah.
And last year, we also increased it for the highest bracket. So, you know, the options to increase personal income tax were limited because, in fact, when you look at the collection now in the financial year that's just passed, day before yesterday, we found that we had not collected a lot of our personal income tax, over 22 billion rand.
So yeah.
It actually wasn't giving us the revenue we needed.
And so this is the quickest and easiest way in order to get that revenue that you need is by increasing VAT. Something that's been spoken about for a long time, but it's never been touched. But this year, it has been touched. One thing I haven't asked previous guests before, and I think you can help us here, comparing ourselves to the rest of the world. Now, I don't necessarily want to compare ourselves to markets like the UK or America, those sort of economies that are more stable. I want to talk about emerging markets. Where do we stand in comparison when it comes to VAT?
Look, whether you look at emerging markets or you look at advanced economies, we stand on the low side. In fact, many of our neighboring countries, except for Botswana, kind of are over 14%. They tend to be 16-17% or more. So we were at the low end, and I think the question you ask, you know, I mean, what could we do? Yes, we VAT was just the least regressive tax that we could impose and had the least impact on growth. Look, all taxes can do mean that you end up paying more and have an impact on growth that's not positive. This was the least bad, in a sense.
Yeah.
And together with all the zero-rated items and VAT exam services, ours is actually not regressive. Many academics or independent studies have found that our VAT is not as regressive or actually almost neutral.
So there's a lot of people that are questioning the zero-rated products and the list of 19 items that are there. And people saying, you know, but this is not a staple. These are not staples. Yes, they are, but there's so much more that should be added. Is there still a chance that this list is going to be increased and you'll see more products added to this?
Look, the minister has announced that there's going to be a panel under the auspices of the Davis Tax Committee, which is going to be chaired by Professor Ingrid Woolard. This will be, we'll announce more details in the next week or two, but she will have a panel of eminent experts who'll review the current zero-rated list. They'll also be looking at whether the food basket of the poor has changed over the last 20 years and come up with suggestions. Having said that, they still need to do it within a fiscal framework.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I'll give an example. If you put a basic item of meat, you'll find that it could take away 6 billion rands in revenue. Okay, so if you're going to create that hole, you've got to kind of find either another revenue source, or you've got to review some of the other items that are in the basket, the zero rating basket. So it's going to be a tough one, but we think, let's get a panel of experts, let them look at the food basket of poor and low income households. And let me say, I saw a bit of your of the earlier interview. You know, the difficult choice is, for example, we zero rate bread, brown bread. We don't zero rate white bread.
I saw that, yes.
So the issue of, you know, should we only zero rate sort of healthy items? Unfortunately, it also seems like a lot of the zero rating on healthy items, it's mainly the richer people who would benefit as well. So there's this dilemma that government has between poor and rich households.
Yeah. Let's not forget as well that we've got the sugar tax coming in. Talk to me more about this, because now when we talk about items affected, obviously we're talking fizzy drinks, sweets, chocolates. What else? What else gets affected by the sugar tax?
Okay, it's a sugary beverage tax.
So it's a sugary beverage tax.
It's not a sugar tax.
Okay.
Not a tax on
sugar. So I'm not going to be paying more for a packet of sugar?
No. But you will be paying more if you go and buy a fizzy drink like Coke or Fanta, etc. Which, you know, these drinks tend to have 9 to 13 teaspoons of sugar. They lead to obesity. So that tax is a very good tax, because the issue is that people consume a lot of it. There's not much nutritional value. It adds to obesity. It adds to health problems. And I think that this is the first signal that government is taking action on such drinks, trying to educate people that, you know, you can't have too much of these drinks, that children also should be restrained from having fizzy drinks all the time. So, you know, sometimes when you increase the tax, like with the sugar beverage tax, and next year the minister had also announced the carbon tax. Okay, that's a tax on emissions.
Yeah.
Those are taxes not designed for revenue, but they're designed to make bad consumption more expensive, or to pay what we call the price of externality. In other words, the harm that's done to society, how do you compensate for it?
Yeah, just we wrap the interview right now. We've got to go to an ad break. But just, I suppose, in one answer, is this decision permanent? Is there any way of reversing it? There's strike action pending. There's a big civil movement against this. Is it permanent? Is there a chance it could be reversed? Yes or no?
Look, government is in a tough position. We do need to raise the revenue, and I think that. You know, that doesn't mean we don't engage with various groups and we try and mitigate the impact of any tax increase. But I think
this
it's highly unlikely that it will be reversed.
So the answer is
you've got to find the revenue,
permanent.
Otherwise it's going to impact on our investment.
Okay. All right. We leave it there, Ishmael, because I think it's a difficult situation for Treasury to be in. And I think that giving you a clear indication, as much as there will be an outcry by civil society, and there is very little that Treasury can do at this point. Ishmael Monette is the Deputy Director General responsible for Tax and Financial Sector Policy at the National Treasury. We take a break.